was born, there were many complications. She had to spend the first couple weeks of her life in the NICU at Dominican Hospital. That's the newborn intensive care unit. And as a matter of fact, if it wasn't for Facebook, I wouldn't even have known she was born because her mother and I weren't together during the pregnancy at all, which just added to the complications. I just got out of the hospital after a horrific car accident, and I was really in no shape to be gallivanting around, you know, but news of my daughter's birth motivated my ass to get down to the hospital and find out. The first moment I held my daughter, I had what most people refer to as a moment of clarity. I knew in that very instant what unconditional love really meant, and I also knew that if I didn't change my ways, she might grow up without a father. And I couldn't bear the thought of that. Her mother had been up to some very questionable behavior before giving birth, and so CPS was involved almost immediately. I had to jump through hoop after hoop to prove I'm so sober and safe and fit to be her sole care provider. You're not going to hear very many men tell you they like to change diapers, but I'm here to tell you I love it. In comparison to all the heartache and tragedy we've had to endure in the last year, changing a few diapers a day is an absolute joy. The other thing about changing diapers is it's always exciting to you because you never know what you're going to get. If you haven't ever changed a diaper, you probably will someday, and it can get messy. That's why this is good to know. I'm a single father, and I've probably changed over 1,000 diapers in the last year. My good mom. There's no real fun way to change a diaper, but like anything else, it requires skill, and that takes practice to develop. My demonstration is going to go over supplies, technique, and ways to avoid a diaper rash. Okay, now that you know what I'm trying to teach you, let's give this a shot. You're going to need a splash guard, and some bottles. What you're really going to need is a new diaper because the old one won't be good anymore. Plenty of wipes because, like I said earlier, this can get messy. And last but not least, powder and cream. I like to refer to these two items as the Cadillac because it makes you feel good. We're going to start off by laying the baby down gently, unfastening the Velcro from the front of the diaper, and as you remove the diaper, you lift up the legs and secure them, and slide the diaper away, because otherwise she'll kick and this can get messy. The general rule is about four wipes. It's nice to have these ready and accessible. You're only going to use each wipe once, and only wipe front to back to avoid irritation or cross-contamination. Place each wipe in the diaper, the old diaper, before discarding. And apply the Cadillac. Next, you're going to stage up the new diaper. Wrap it around and apply the Velcro to the front of the diaper. Okay, now that the hard part's out of the way, there's a few more things I'd like to touch on. Avoiding a diaper rash is much easier than treating one. That's why I almost always apply powder and cream, because it might seem like overkill, but trying to treat a diaper rash is much worse. Also, pay very close attention to what you're feeding your child, because if it's irritating her or creating a rash, you want to stop feeding them that particular food. My daughter can't eat wheat or oats in abundance. That's why I just don't feed it to her. Also, bathe your baby daily. Cleanliness is godliness. It's also one of the most important ways to avoid a rash. Okay, now that the hard part's out of the way, hope that you guys, if you ever have to change a diaper, you remember this presentation, because nobody talks about changing diapers when you're expecting a child. Hopefully you'll know what you need, a technique, and that you don't get a rash. Don't be afraid to practice, because practice makes perfect. And go ahead and dive right in, because shit happens.